Hello everyone, this is TechieSnake and in this video, we'll have a look at the Xiaomi 100 watts car charger, which is at the moment the world's fastest car charger. Let's begin. This charger costs only $24 and the box I received was damaged, but luckily the internals were unharmed. The front side of the box mentions key features such as 100 watt support, USB-C and USB-A ports. The back side has some more details. Inside the box, you get the main Xiaomi 100 watts car charger, 1 meter long USB-C to C charging cable, and the user manual in Chinese. My first impression on the build quality is that it has a nice, solid and premium feel. It has a traditional shape of a car charger with a metal elastic contact design, which is suitable for cigarette lighters and power outlets in most cars. The body is made of polycarbonate material and the rough finishing is skid and abrasion resistant, making it durable and long lasting. It comes with two ports, USB-C and USB-A, and can be used to charge two devices simultaneously. USB-A outputs a maximum of 18 watts, whereas the USB-C when used alone can support up to 100 watts of power. It's important to note that when using two devices simultaneously together, the maximum power output will be limited to 68 watts. The charger comes equipped with a USB automatic matching or control chip, which makes it safe to use with most electronic equipment. Since the package already includes a USB-C to C cable, you don't have to buy one, which will save you some money. The cable has a built-in e-marker chip that supports 5 ampere high current to reach the 100 watts output. It can be used safely to charge mobile phones, laptops, and other USB-C interface devices without any issues. If you have made it so far in the video, a sub would really help energize me. Now let's take this charger to the car and put it to work. One of the coolest features on the charger is the indicator lights that really looks good at night. In the standby state, the indicator light will be white. When charging low power devices, it displays a green light. For medium power devices, it will show a blue light, and for high power devices, it will display a golden light. Now I'm going to test the USB-C port for maximum power output on different devices such as iPhone 11, Xiaomi Redmi K20 Pro, and Dell XPS 15 laptop. Before this test, I had completely discharged the battery of each device so it would pull out maximum power when plugged in. As expected, the phones were charging close to their maximum ratings. The iPhone 11 was charging at about 21 watts and the Redmi K20 Pro charged at around 25 watts. For the laptop, it was taking in around 43 to 44 watts. This should be enough for most laptops. However, I was wondering why I could not get 100 watts even though the laptop supported up to 130 watts. I went back to check more details and I found that 100 watts will only work on Xiaomi fast charge devices such as Xiaomi 10 Extreme, Ultra or similar. This means that only compatible Xiaomi fast charge products would get up to 100 watts from this charger. In the description, you'll find the compatible fast charging protocols supported on this charger for reference. Now let us see if the charger overheats while in operation. I use both the ports to charge my iPhone and laptop with fully discharged batteries. The initial temperature of the charger was recorded around 29 centigrade. After 2 hours of continuous charging at 68 watts power output, the temperature increased to a maximum of 47 centigrade. In my opinion, this should not pose any overheating concern and should be totally acceptable. In conclusion, the 100 watts on this charger is only achievable with Xiaomi fast charge compatible devices. If you own Xiaomi fast charge phones and laptops, this car charger is a no-brainer. For others, it is still a great option due to its dual USB ports, combined 68 watts power output, excellent build quality, and all of this at a price point of less than $25. That's all I have to say in this video about this charger. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe. See you again.